So this is the remaining quarterfinal in the men's singles here at these WTT Finals Men Doha 2023. The defending champion, Wang Chuqin, in a repeat here of last year's final that he won over Tomokazu Harimoto.
It'll definitely feel different for the players too. So much has happened in between their previous encounters.
Yeah, well, that's not the most recent meeting. They've met, as you suggest, they've met a couple of times this season. Wang winning both of those, now losing a game. Overall, champions Macau went on to win that semis 4-0. And the team event of the Asian champs, 3-0. Quarterfinals there, but Harimoto has beaten him before. That's what makes this intriguing. That's him keeping it simple. And that's when he's at his best, Harimoto.
Exactly. And it's the players who can do the simple things the best that are the best. You know what Harimoto's going to bring. You know he's going to stay close. You know he's going to try and switch you about. But it's which way he goes. Spinning that, nice percentages from Wang Chuqin. Lots of rotation into the middle of Harimoto. He's going to have to show a little bit more initiative with the footwork than that.
And that's an area, yeah, finds the pocket again. I mean, it's an area I know you've analysed quite a bit. We've done a lot of Harimoto's matches where he's been upset. Matches this season, covered a lot of them. And it's an area you feel, I know, Fraser, that for all his gifts, the footwork is an area that you look at those previous meetings that Wang Chuqin has managed to exploit that area of Harimoto's game.
That one was nice there. Got low, made the space, played a beautiful winner with the forehand. But yeah, Harimoto has to play to win. You can't rely on your opponent to miss. Can't play not to lose, if you will. Take advantage of everything. Make your own luck. Oh. Try the angle there, but I mean, Wang Chuqin, we see it both in singles and doubles. Throws the kitchen sink at you. Full commitment. I mean, that is a very taxing shot on the body.
Yeah, free willing.
Which is imperious from Wang.
Yeah. Oh, we talk about it. I mean, as a defending champion first up, because he had Felix Lebrun, and he had to be fully focused, as he admitted. Yeah. The student that he is, saying that he'd been studying and has been studying Felix. Of course, he's got plenty to study ahead of this one. Yeah, just back on the footwork thing again, I think. Point you make with Harimoto is the footwork can be dynamic, but it can also get passive. And if it's passive here, he's got virtually zero chance of winning here. However, it's dynamic.
Yeah.
So the time his chances rise.
It's not about the footwork during the shot. In fixed positions, he's amazing, almost unplayable. But it's what he does in between shots to set himself up. He likes to dictate with the backhand, but he can penetrate more, it seems, with the forehand. And that's just because of the amount of leverage, the amount you can really slingshot with the forehand. You can put more body into it. You can sweep that right leg back. With the backhand, you just kind of have to be squared to the table. You can produce a lot of power and spin, don't get me wrong, but can't produce as hard of a shot against lower loops.
That's it. Intriguing point there, almost back. He's clawing his way back, but Wang moves 2 points from the opening game. Oh, best of the lot so far in some ways. He seemed very, very low percentage to take that on Arimoto, but he made it.
I thought he was going to get stuck there, but look at that with the open body, the closed racket angle.
He made one of those against Ovtcharov, actually, similar to that. Yes, for Harry. Yeah, a little bit there, a little bit of... He's come to play here.
This was clutch. Look how low he took that one. Amazing. Not in full position, so he played with more spin, slower, and it skidded along the surface. Fantastic shot selection in a crucial moment.
And what you've actually urged of him through the season to add more of, to do that.
Yes, variation.
And it applies pressure. There is the pressure. How often do you see that? He's seen those last couple of points, Wayne.
And he's felt like his serve has to be really good. Yeah. Maybe that's why he missed.
Game point, Harimoto. Is that just the level that he'd set? Not quite. You know, as a push, is it dynamic enough?
I think it was a good idea, but I think he actually just put too much on it. Would have been better off just using the pace on the serve. Not really putting too much into that.
It's turning into a compelling opening game, isn't it? Wang will have his chance now to take it. He saved a game point previous. Slips by for Arimoto, hence the double stamp. But it was too heavy, too
just
high.
A bit too heavy-handed, yeah.
Now, he can't be feeling sorry for himself here, though. He played a great opening game, Arimoto. But the standard that Wang invariably sets, Arimoto's got to look to maintain at the very least, and he raises. Said after the win, I was going to ask you, actually, Fraser, is it relevant? I think the answer is it was very good preparation, but get your thoughts on it. About the win over Dmitry Ovtcharov. Very different player, of course, to the one he's up against here. But just for his confidence, said, because he thought Ovtcharov played great. Obviously, such a gritty competitor, but focused on the fifth game.
Yeah.
And how he approached it. And therefore, what he could take into this match. I think that's an interesting point to explore.
Yeah. See, they know each other's game so well, Harimoto and Ovtcharov, because obviously Harimoto's been playing in the German League and the Champions League. And yeah, I mean, we've seen this event, haven't we, so much, the theme of it's difficult to beat a friend, someone who knows your game, not just because you played each other on the international stage. We've seen it with Aruna and Ugo. We saw it with Harimoto and Dima, and we saw it, of course, just then with Ma Long and Ming Gai Wen. No coincidence all those games went to five.
Yeah, there aren't many secrets here between these two as well, it being a 10th meeting and mention the fact it goes all the way back to the Youth Olympics. Third meeting this season as well. More than that, it's happening here. Over the table, immaculate.
Timed it really nicely there. Pops up, it's how early the players can almost instinctively know, okay, this is going to be flickable, but not really attackable. With a kind of Lee Sang-soo swoop. Slower. Just dangled, didn't it, in front of Harimoto. Off the half long. Slight kick of side spin threw off the Japanese. It's his nose back in front here, Dato.
Oh, wait there and waiting for it. Anticipated so well there, Harumoto.
Ambushed.
Long as well there. He's thinking very clearly out here. I come back to a point again, because we've commentated quite a few of his matches, losses actually in the season, if you think about it. Wounding losses. But you said about him, you don't want to depart completely from what he does so well. I think sometimes, Fraser, you said it yourself, kind of self-critical, you kind of come out of the commentary box and said, I'm being too critical of Tomokazu Harumoto here. It's not that. It's actually 20 years old. He's an incredible player. But it's these, you've got to make the fractional adjustments. Maybe he's not been willing so much, whatever reason, to do that during the season. I guess losing matches puts you away from that a bit. But we're seeing here variations.
You can't focus on one thing too much. And for me, I just got the sense for quite a while that he didn't really want to play his forehands more than his backhands, Harumoto. You've got to be willing to do anything at any time, depending on who you're up against. Can't think too hard about one thing on its own. It's the blend. I mean, you were talking about it with me and Frankfurt. It's the blend of things. It's how you control, and all these guys have a toolkit full of weapons, but it's choosing the right one at the right time.
This being, as you say, these two contemporaries went up to point. You had Arimoto's big reaction and then Wang responds in kind. Well, it was a timeout called by Arimoto's coach. So, of course, here Wang resuming with the service there. It's that first point on the resumption. These are massive moments here. I think he had a game point in the first. All in the second, and now Wang here off the timeout comes out and puts those two together.
So good, every element of it. I mean, the first shovel serve he did was a kicker, it had topspin, then going with backspin. And just in case Harumoto reads it, which he did well, having that, having the blocks and then the full extension on the second one, just to add a bit of a juxtaposition. Enough of one to trouble Harumoto. And then that as well.
I mean, a hat trick. Tomokazu Harumoto here, two down. In the best of five. Talk a lot, Fraser, about... I mean, Harumoto's played very well for large parts of this match so far, but in the key moments, talk about presence. And if you like, chest out a bit more and bringing it at the table and come out of that timeout that was called, remember, by Dong at 8-all. And the way Wang came out, those 3 points... it was quite simple.
It was awesome. The minerals of Wang Chichen, he's got them. Looking to be the first left-handed world champion since the Frenchman, Jean Gatien. Philippe Gatien, that is.
Yeah, he's got to wait a little while for that. Of course, world champs, the next singles will take place here in Doha. In the longer view, will be ambition. This is you feel here. This is moving away from Harumoto after a tight couple of games. He's not been able to win either of them. So the towel break still trails by two. Needs to channel Chengdu. Team feeling here, Harumoto. Remember that team. I mean, that was harsh, wasn't it, on Japan? He beats Fan Zhendong and Wang Chuqin, and they still lose. Beat them both. Can he channel that here?
That's why I say, I mean, Hanamoto kind of relies on momentum. He feeds off the crowd. He almost needs the crowd. If they were playing in a white, empty room with no one there, who would win? Just him and his opponent. You'd probably say Wang Chuqin, because he's more of a kind of guy that is here to take what he believes is his.
Easy does it. Lead back up to two. Too much there from Wang. It's a point back. I just remember Fraser when you identified, you know, spoken about it over years, all the talents from the Chinese national team. And you identified this man. Said he's going to be absolutely special. He could dominate. Sports developed a bit since then even, but I mean, you look at the successes he's had at 23 years of age, what he's done already, and as you suggest, the future targets, the goals, the aspirations.
Yeah. And it hasn't come quickly for him. It's taken time, it's been a work in progress. Don't forget, he had a three-month ban after tossing a racket in a way which no other player from a different country would get banned. It was almost delayed for him, and when he came, it was more fuel to the fire. And there's already so much fire in the heart of Lionheart. And looking to roar again. Mm. When he smells that blood, you know.
Yeah, looking to devour this long-time foe. Again, he's on the way to it, the Lionheart.
Try the high toss serve there. Not often you see Hanamoto going for that. Just trying something different, but it's far too little too late. And I'm saying too late. It's coming too late. There is still, for me, too much of a safety in the game of Tomokazu Hanamoto. Too many junior aspects. He can't afford to continue if he wants to even remain at world number 11 as a senior.
He'll take it. Needs it. Still trails by three here, Hanamoto. Dripping here from the defending champion. Match points. Oh, and that as well. Well, the title defence remains firmly on track for Wang Chuqin.